Since you're more than likely not going to have GParted installed on your Ubuntu setup initially, open a terminal session using the super key. Once it opens, type sudo apt install gparted. Enter your password if you're prompted to do so. Press Y to begin the installation when prompted. Once the installation is complete, type gparted and press enter to start the program. You should be prompted to enter your password in a dialog box. Go ahead and do that. If your device isn't recognized immediately, don't panic. Simply pull out your thumb drive, reinsert it, and select the device from the pull-up menu under Devices, USB, your device name, and model. GParted will need to be refreshed by closing and reopening the program. So go ahead and close out GParted if you're having this issue, and then reopen GParted with whatever method you feel is appropriate. Re-enter your password and press enter. In the drop-down menu in the top left corner of the app, select your flash drive. Most likely, your drive will be the drive that is formatted in FAT32, which can be found in the second column of information in the main window. Right-click your drive and hover over Format 2. Format the drive to the dark blue ext4 file system. Click the green check mark above to start formatting the drive. Continue by clicking Apply. Once it is said, all operations successfully completed, go ahead and click the Close button. You'll want to make sure that your drive is easily recognizable, so right-click the drive and select Label File System. Name the drive whatever you wish. Here I'm naming it Ubuntu 18.04 USB. Click the check mark again to apply these changes, and then click the Apply button. Again, as before, once you receive the All Operations Successfully Completed dialog, go ahead and click Close. Open the MKUSB app from Dash by pressing the Super key. On the Run USB Dust dialog, select Yes to run the graphical user interface. Type your password to continue. Press OK to do USB stuff. Here we're going to install Make a Boot Device, so select that option and click OK. Next, select the third option, Persistent Live, Only Debian and Ubuntu option, and then click OK. Locate your Ubuntu 18.04 ISO on the desktop, select it, and then click OK. On the next section of the wizard, it should already list your USB drive in the dropdown and its size. Select its radio button if there is more than one device and click OK. To make this device easily bootable in Windows, select the MS-DOS partition table and click OK. This is the single most important part of the entire video and possibly the only reason why many of you are here. This slider will determine the size of the remaining space on your thumb drive. So, if you have a 64GB thumb drive and Ubuntu will utilize approximately 3 gigs of that, then the 61GB remaining is what this particular section of the wizard is talking about. This is going to be converted to a separate EXT4 formatted Casper RW partition on your flash drive. Since it is recommended not to exceed 95% of the remaining disk space, go ahead and set that bar right at 95. Once this very important step is completed, click the OK button. Verify your changes in this window, select the Go Radio button, afterward click the full-on Go button at the bottom. You should then be prompted to install the USB Pack EFI. Go ahead and click Yes. Due to the fact that both apt-get update and apt-get upgrade can be performed at a later time that is more secure than this session, go ahead and click No to begin immediately creating the flash drive. Wait for a while as your now fully utilized USB drive is being created. Once you get the green highlighted Work Done With Insert Drive Location here, click OK. To verify your new device, head over to GParted. Since GParted will not refresh due to the drive configuration, go ahead and close and reopen the program. Once your drives load, it may default to your inserted thumb drive. If not, you can select the drive from the top right dropdown. Your drive configuration should look very similar to what's shown here. A very large Casper RW partition will exist that will maintain all of your changes within the drive. Once all of this is complete, you can shut down your PC and boot from the newly made thumb drive. Thank you all so much for stopping by and watching my video. If you like what you see, go ahead and click the subscribe button below. Please do leave your comments and let me know what you might like to see me do next time. Anything is welcome. So until next time, namaste.